Hello everybody. Today we're going to pick a challenge lock. Right out of the box here. This one was sent by the Bronx Lock Picker. It is the Putz number 4, pinned by Pickaholic. Nice stainless Brinks there. Let's put this thing away. Get the rubber band off. Key's mummied. So hopefully I won't forget to show you that. And then let's slide over here. Throw it in the vise. And let's see if we can't get this thing open today. Haven't picked it yet. But I sure will let you know if I have picked a lock before. So we're gonna go with and try a 50 here. Yep, that'll work. I'm gonna try this this new pick I got from Big Willie, the locksmith. This standard hook, short hook. So yeah. Here we go. Hold on. Alright, number 5. Give me a little click. Got a couple clicks off of 4. A little rotation, I think. Got some out of 3. Ooh, got some good counter off of 2. I think it's set. Let's try 1. Got a click off of 1. Ooh. Looks like 4. Got some counter off 4 and a click. Nice. Another click at a 3. Feels like counter from 1. I'm going to overset that guy. Got a little rotation on the core from 3. Click on 2. 4 seemed to have dropped down. Got some counter off 4. Alright. Small rotation. Feels pretty bound up. Oh, counter off of 3 again. I don't think I set him, but there we go, some more rotation. Click out of 3, it had some counter, still counter. I think it's set though. Let's see here. Boy, this is a good lock. Well done, Pickaholic. Keeping me in suspense here. Keep running into counter, rotation, and a slight false set. Not a whole lot going on there, getting some clicking. Keep dropping stuff in that counter rotation. Yeah, get a lot of counter off of 3, and then it drops 4 and 5. Starting to think now. Everything seems pretty bound up. What a great lock. For number four, yeah, this is terrific. Okay. Click out of three and four. Still going back and forth with counter. Must be an awesome spool in there or something. Really like this pick. Feels like, I don't know, like it's 19 thousandths, I guess. I don't have a micrometer. Well, I got that old German one off to the side, but it's not digital. It only goes in 30 seconds. Got a good fall set going now. Feels like we're getting somewhere on this guy. Got super light tension. Everything's bound up. Oh, we're open. Three gave me some counter and let us right open. Oh boy, 6 minutes into a lock. That's great. All right, let's see what we need here. Get the old pinning tray out. Still working. I've got my carpenter guy. I gave him a piece of ironwood. And he said he'd route it out for me. Good friend of mine. He's a busy guy, though, so we're working on the pinning tray. Let's set that there. Move you guys down. Badoop. All right. Let's try this new tool that we got from Pick Me 1977's 500 subscriber giveaway. And look at that. It works awesome. Awesome. Thank you, Pick Me. What a wonderful giveaway that was. I still am in shock I won. As you can see, I got the pick roll on display. Cherishing that proudly. Can't seem to get the spring out. So I'll leave it in there. All right, let's see what we got in here. Oh, better use a shim. Sometimes I forget to use a shim, and that would be a catastrophe if I got it all locked up. All right, that went out smooth. Looks like it's got threading. Well, we'll start with one. It's got some counter milling. Threading in two. Nothing in three. Threading in four and five. Let's dump these guys out. Some nice pins there. Oh, wow. And number five. Check out what he's got up top here. Nice long spool. Got a steel spring. Another awesome spool. Steel spring. Another spool. Hope everybody's having a wonderful weekend. Great Saturday. I know mine's been going pretty good. Working in the shop on some stuff. Always afraid to. Where did number three go? Oh, there it goes. having a hard time with number four. We'll come back to that guy. There we go. All right, it's out. So I don't forget, we'll look up in there right now. And the Bible doesn't look like nothing was done up there. Okay, check. Got that. Let's look at these pins. Well, first let me find that key. What did I do with the key? Yeah. There's the bidding on that. Pretty good. Pretty nice low cut there. Awesome. Now let's check out these pretty awesome pins. For number four lock, that is an awesome lock. That was quite fun, challenging. Lots of feedback on that. All right, let me get a little pointer here. Got my little homemade street sweeper diamond. Okay, number one, we got a small serration. Number two is a double serrated. Three is a long, it's like a tapered with a couple serrations. It's also a reduced diameter. Two is a couple serrations. Three is like a serrated reduced diameter. The driver's number one is a long spool there. Pretty cool long spool. And then here we got a spool, a real sharp one. That is a nice pin. Here we got a like a double spool, almost kind of barely. Number four, looks like a slightly reduced serrated, or no, it's a shallow spool. And here we got a serrated, it's got a couple steps to it. So it's like reduced in the middle, pretty nice. All steel springs. Yeah, it looks like that. So yeah, hey, hope you like watching me struggle with this lock a little bit. Definitely a fun lock there, Pickaholic. Great job. Thank you, Bronx, for sending it to me. You guys take care, be well, and behave.